Let's discuss about cause of abortion. So we'll discuss the cause of spontaneous abortion, cause of recurrent abortions, and in recurrent causes we'll discuss cause of first trimester recurrent abortion, and next we'll discuss about cause of second trimester recurrent abortion. Right, so let's first move into spontaneous abortions. The most common cause of first trimester second trimester spontaneous abortion is chromosomal anomaly is the most common cause of first trimester and second trimester spontaneous abortion. These chromosomal anomalies, 95% of them, they are formed during maternal gametogenesis, and remaining 5% they are formed during paternal gametogenesis. The most common chromosomal anomaly that causes first trimester and second trimester spontaneous abortion is aneuploidy. Right, if take in a order the causes of first trimester and second trimester spontaneous abortion, if take in order, aneuploidy greater than trisomy, greater than monosomy X, greater than trisomy 16. So if you are given these four answers in MCQs, then the first best answer is aneuploidy, second best answer is trisomy, third best answer is monosomy X, and fourth best answer is trisomy 16. Okay, so this order you have to remember. See, these are abortion seen in babies who are having chromosomal anomalies. Then move to the cause of abortion in case of euploid babies. That means the babies who are having who don't have any chromosomal anomalies. The cause of abortion in babies who are having good number of chromosomes. That means 46 chromosomes. The cause is usually in maternal. There will be maternal cause for abortion in case of euploid babies. And especially if the mother age is greater than 35 years, the chance will be more. Okay, if the age of mother is greater than 35 years of age, then the chance of abortion in case of euploid babies will be more. And moreover, these euploid babies will be aborted later than aneuploid babies. Usually these euploid babies will be aborted maximum during 13th week, whereas aneuploid babies usually aborted during 8th week most commonly. Okay, this point you have to remember. And then moving to cause of recurrent abortions. First we'll discuss cause of first trimester recurrent abortion. We'll discuss first trimester recurrent abortion. The causes are most commonly it is idiopathic, and other causes include endocrine causes, anatomical factors like uterine leiomyomas Asserman syndrome, Muller and duct anomalies, incompetent os. Okay, then inherited thrombophilias, then chromosomal anomalies. Okay, the most common chromosomal anomaly that causes recurrent abortion is balanced translocation of chromosomes. Okay, then moving to the causes during second trimester. The most common cause being cervical incompetence. Cervical incompetence. Overall, the most common cause of recurrent abortion are parental chromosomal abnormalities, antiphospholipid antibody syndrome, and uterine abnormalities. Okay, we can divide cause of abortion into fetal factors, maternal factors, and paternal factors. In case of fetal factors, we have chromosomal abnormalities. These are, as I told you, these are the most common causes of first trimester and second trimester spontaneous abortion, hydrophobic degeneration of leg, and multiple pregnancies. These are the fetal causes of abortion. Then moving to maternal factors, maternal infections like TORS infections, malaria, uroplasma, chlamydia, brucella, spirochetes. And one thing I forgot to tell you about infection is, infections usually do not cause recurrent abortions. Infections, they do not cause recurrent abortion. But one infection that can lead to recurrent abortion is syphilis. That you have to remember, that I forgot to tell you. So the maternal infections like TORS infection, malaria, uroplasma, chlamydia, brucella, spirochetes. Then maternal medical conditions like hypertension, chronic renal diseases, cyanotic heart diseases, hemoglobinopathies. Environmental factors like alcohol, smoking causes early pregnancy loss. Okay, caffeine, exposure to radiation, the amount of radiation is greater than 5 rads. Anesthetic gases, endocrine problems like luteal phase defect. In luteal phase defect, when there is deficiency of progesterone, it can lead to abortion. Okay, thyroid abnormalities like hypothyroidism, poorly controlled diabetes mellitus, polycystic ovarian disease, hyperprolactinemia, and other maternal causes like immunological causes include antiphospholipid antibody syndrome, inherited thrombophilias, and uterine factors like cervical incompetency, Muller anomalies. These are most commonly associated with abortions in septate uterus, large and multiple submucous gliomas, Asserman syndrome, large and multiple submucous gliomyoma, and DEC exposure in utero, and weight of the mother. Underweight or nutritional deficiency does not lead to abortion. Okay, underweight or nutritional deficiency does not lead to abortion. Obesity can lead to abortion. Okay, other factors include trauma, subchorionic hematoma, and defective placentation. Okay, and then moving to paternal factors, increased paternal age. This is the only cause we have under paternal factor, increased age.